topic is World Trade Organization, as we call as WTO. World Trade Organization was established on 1st January 1995 by the member of nations of United Nations. Its headquarters is located in Geneva in Switzerland. Now let's see why this WTO was established. What were the objectives of WTO? First, to remove obstacle influencing global trading, to remove protection policy given to the industries of country for foreign trade, so that there will be a coordination with global trade policies and economical policies. Its main objective was also to solve the trade related dispute arising in the world. Now how the WTO works, that is the functions, let's see. To set up required structure for implementation of agreement related to multinational trade and agreement related to it. Second, World Trade Organization plays a vital role for the debate and negotiation for multinational trade. It encourages unbiased international trade. Also, different nations follow their own national policies. It observes them and suggests required improvement. Now, let's see what are the impacts of Indian economy of WTO. Now, first is India contribution to the world trade was 5%. Now, after export have increased tremendously due to the increase in international trade, and as a result of India, contribution in the world has increased to 1%, that is 0.5 to 1%. Now, second is, being a member of WTO, exports of ready-made clothes of our country has increased. India has been able to increase exports of agro product also. Now, due to the increase in export, pressure on imports has been reduced and foreign investment has been increased in foreign exchange. So we can say, as a member of World Trade Organization, India will not only get above mentioned but benefits also, it has some different others policies which helps it. Now India, its infrastructure facilities and development of countries also is being helped by WTO. Now next topic of this our chapter is sustainable development. Now what exactly it is? It means sustainable development is a development which meets the needs of the present generation without compromising with the ability of the future generation to meet their own needs. What we can say, the main idea of sustainable development, in a simple language, we can say whatever resources or whatever things which we are using in the present generation, which are needed in the present generation and development, it should be now maintained in such a way that it cannot affect in the future generation. That is, that we always have the fear that luxurious which present generation is enjoying may not be there for the future generation. Now, tremendous there is a decrease in natural resources due to economical development, and their qualities is also destroying. So a sustainable development helps for this. Now let us see the strategies which we have adopted for the conservation and preservation. Now first one is that the renewable natural resources like cultivable farm, forest, water resources, it should be used in such a way that the quality is maintained. And non-renewable natural resources like coal, petroleum, minerals should be used in a very judicial manner. Second, eco-friendly development. What it means, eco-friendly development, that means industrial location should be decided on the basis of the lesser transportation cost. Seniors attempt should be made to achieve the whole concept of eco-friendly development. Now third is, those resources which can be used in more than one way should be utilized in different ways. such as different irrigation system, utilization for more than one person, for example, producing electricity, flood controls, transportation. Here I can give you the example of water. If there is a lot of water in the river, we should have build a dam or dam so that the water can be stopped due to the flood. Water, the water should not be wasted in the flood. Instead, we can save this water. We can say use the water in the irrigation purpose also. We can use the same water for producing electricity also. Now the fourth is natural resources should not be wasted. Control should be laid on that unplanned disposal of industrial waste, poisonous chemicals, increasing slums, etc. Now the fifth one, the last one, is stress should be laid on use of non-conventional energy resources such as solar energy, wind energy. We have studied about it lot, that how electricity is produced with the help of wind energy, hydroelectricity, then solar energy, how can we use solar energy in solar cooker, solar cell, many other things. How can we produce electricity with the solar energy? So this type of non-conventional energy we should use. Now last topic in this chapter is steps which we can take to protect our environment. Now, first time Earth Conference was organized in 1972 at Stockholm in Sweden. Now, always this type of step, this was the first time when all the organization came to gather for the protection of environment at the global level. Now, what are the governments, all which government is also making efforts to help in this protecting environment? Let's see. First, information about pollution condition of different cities of the nation is presented, so that we come to know which area or which city has more pollution. Second, central and state pollution control board have been established to control pollution. 5th June has been declared as Environmental Day in the world. Then Air Pollution Control Act 1981 was set up by the Indian government. Now last one, international agreements have also been made or signed to determine the level of ozone, disposal of nuclear waste, and maintenance of biodiversity. In the end, I will tell, conservation of environment is everyone's responsibility. If we do not control pollution, no doubt the life on the earth will be doomed soon.